I feel a bit sick today. Yesterday I got my third vaccine, and since then I have felt a bit feverish. Not enough, though, not to stumble into a few lines regarding horses in Latvia. The very first horses hanging around the nowadays Baltic states were the tarpans, small horses from the Russian steppes, like some sort of larger, shorter, sturdier mustangs from America, but gray with a black stripe over their back and strong legs. A nice and tiny gray horse, bigger than a pony, I guess. When the population moved within the territory of Latvia, as the Ice Age receded, this became lunch, dinner, and breakfast. What was left of the lady horses, though, later on in history, was used by the Crusaders to breed war horses. And for those who didn't go to war, there was only little food but plenty of work in the field that they grew formidably strong and resistant. Years were gone, and Latvian beasts got a taste of Islam by copulating with no less than the Arabian horse from whom a new and scary breeding stallion appeared in Riga at the end of the 19th century. But if the old saying, "You can't lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink," is true, all of these crazy animals are more complicated than we think. Or maybe we should never look a gift horse in the mouth. Who knows? Dinah, maybe. Dinah, welcome. How are you today?
Hello, good. A little bit tired because this is the evening. Because I have now just a 3 hour training session.
Ah, like at work, you mean?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Remind me what you do.
Human resources specialist about system, time and attendance, data entries, hiring people in system. It's all about systems.
Managing the situation with the staff, which is located not just in Latvia but also in
It's
Austria, I understand.
located only in Austria and a little bit Italian.
Little bit of yes, that's why we know each other.
Yes.
Also, I still don't know what the company that you work for does. What is it? What do they do?
This is production resins. They create resins, chemical industry, all reactors, production and laboratories about investigating, creating a new lacs or new resins, new dilutions, and so on, like a paint from water-based, green, eco, and so on. It's really manufacturing fabrics in many countries across the globe.
We're not going to say the name for reasons of, we're not going to say the name of the company, but I was just curious because it sounded like that. It sounded like something that it was involved on raw materials and things like that, like working raw materials. It's not raw materials though.
We work with raw materials, yes. For that reason, the raw materials crisis have big impact to our job and our prices and other stuff for salespeople.
Does it come from oil as well? Is oil
Yes.
involved?
Yes.
Well, this doesn't have anything to do with horses,
Nothing to do
which
with horses.
Dana has an incredible passion for horses, and this passion started 10 years ago, I believe, more or less, or even before, maybe.
In the childhood, but this was only a child dreams, but active, yes, 10 years ago, approximately.
You make me want to ask you a question. So when you were a child, you had a dream of having a horse or and something like that as well.
I just want to be next to horse. I was driving a lot of horses at that time, but I was no possibilities to get to horse riding. I didn't even think about it because our situation in family, we had no money for that.
It's not something that is impossible to do, right? It's not too expensive. Is it very expensive nowadays?
If you want to participate in professional competitions, then it could be expensive because all those horses need to be with exactly qualities, what it needs for that discipline. Is it concours or dressage? For that reason, those horses need to be with good parents, and they will cost a lot. And you need to have personal trainer, you need to have much more trainings and that day, and maybe you don't have even one horse, you have two and more to get yourself skills at that high level, that it could be expensive. But for me, it's not so expensive because I don't have such a dreams to participate in those competitions. Never had. I just want to be with horses, learn with how to communicate with them and enjoy being with them.
Totally clear. So there are two aspects to start with. One is the lineage of the horse, family that it comes from, the breed, and whether you want to adopt that for competition. So we're talking almost like racing cars. Competing with horses is very expensive, you're telling me. So things that are connected with breed and anything. I understand is the other thing, which is mostly it has to do with the relationship with the horse and developing their relationship, right? Mostly.
Correct. We have local competitions in our bar, so to say, like summer friendship competitions. That means that all the girls and guys who is regularly going there, learning and teaching, they could take a participation in local competitions to feel that atmosphere in competition. This is good for horse nervous system to develop it, and for the rider, because some riders need to some goal to do exercises. They can't just go every week and ride. They need to some point. Okay, I will train that and that for competition. And they go and have a more motivation to do that.
So even if we're not talking about dealing with horses for the sake of competition, the competition for people that belong to the other group that just want to develop the relationship with the horse, the competitions are good because they give you some sort of objective to follow. Because you say, if I have a good relationship with my horse, the best way to prove that is to by being in a competition.
Yes, because this is a stressing environment and how you deal with your task, but you need to do on your stress itself, because both together not always a good combination. For some horses, they're more sensitive, for example, they feel that you are very stressed and nervous, and for that reason this is a good for people too. It's like a fun competition games. There is some prizes, but it's more about fun, not about points and places.
See what you mean. Exactly, which is the other division, the expensive one.
Yes, it's only about the point and the places, because they need to somehow cover those costs.
And maybe they, since there is money involved in the other group with professional competition and expensive horses, the relationship between the horse rider and the horse is not as good, that good as the other group, right?
No, not exactly. It could be good as well. Is interested in building the relationships to get more better results.
Okay, so you're saying that you can really push a competition horse to a point as long as you have a good relationship with it.
I don't know, maybe with bad relationships will be good, but if the relationships are very bad, that horse won't listen to you, even if he will try to escape because you are not on charge, or he's so afraid that he refuses to do something. Like in those Olympic games, the pretty girl in those competitions, that horse didn't jump. Just not because if horse don't jump for second ask, you lose automatically. You can go away.
So it seems the way that I understand it, tell me if I'm wrong. So we have been talking about two types of dealing with horses and having fun. The one that belongs to you, which is not mainly about competing, but partly sometimes, but mostly about you and developing your relationship with your horse. And on the other side, you have the world of competition. Now, before I ask you a question, can we use the word happy with horse?
If the horse is happy, yes.
Yeah, beautiful. Now, generalizing, a horse that is competing professionally and a horse that belongs to your group, where there is more space for a character developing without the pressure of money and competition and sponsor, in which case the horse is happier?
And this depends from the people who are around the horse. Mm-hmm. They're both horses could be happy. Mm-hmm. It depends how you treat your horse.
Mm-hmm. Right. So tell us a bit. How do you? I want to ask you so many things about you and Kresa, which is the name of your horse. But I also want to provide some sort of basic information for people there in Latvia that want to start doing what you're doing. Because it seems to be every time that we meet each other, I see that you have an extra battery recharged because you have been horse riding. So you seem to be, it is becoming almost like oxygen for you. How do we get to access this beautiful hobby if we live in Latvia?
First one, you need to decide what kind type of riding do you want. Do you want to start in competitions? Do you want just one time going in the woods with horse and then forget? Or you want to build relationship with the horse, understand how he acts, what you need to do to get that feeling like in Avatar?
No, I haven't watched the movie.
Because you are the one with the horse, like one.
One entity.
Yes, this is amazing feeling if you just like one. I try to reach this out. I'm still learning that, but it depends from how often I go there, how I pay attention to my feelings, my movements, how I analyze what I did wrong. But at the same time, I could not be so stressed and tense. I need to be relaxed. So for horse, this is the fun. Mm-hmm. You need to find a place. If you want to do competition, you search for stables who is more concentrated on competitions. Mm-hmm. There is such in not only in Riga, but in outside in Riga, I think no one. My stable is about Natural Horsemanship. Mm-hmm. There's in Latvia other. I think I know other tools. Mm-hmm. One in Čakava, and other one is somewhere in the Balbone, I think. There's a classical way of teaching horse, what mostly are doing. And this is a Natur Horsemanship way of teaching horse. There's a completely different approach how to teach a horse. I don't know about classical a lot. I know about those Natur Horsemanship.
Tell us a bit about Nature Horsemanship, because it sounds like a hippie, beautiful way to teach a horse. Well,
it sounds only beautiful because in some cases this is not very beautiful, but maybe in classical things it's the same. It's all about how the horses communicate each with other. And the song in that way is taking to human-horse relationship. It was done by Parelli in so commercial way. But I think in the past, the cowboys, all the Indians are doing the same. They are feeling the horse. They are not forcing jumping and like making rodeo. No. Natur Horsemanship is about trust and respect.
When you really try to push your horse, your most important tool, it can be called fear or respect. And you said, no, it's respect. Respect seems to be something that goes in two ways, like a two-way highway. Like you do something for your horse and your horse does something for you, something like that.
Yeah.
So Nature Horsemanship comes from a legacy of Indian tradition, maybe from the older times. And
yes, because in Nature Horsemanship we use four levels, like a horse and herd. You know, with the energy, eyes, ears, maybe tail, or virtual kick. We do the same for people with the carrot stick.
What is a virtual kick? Virtual.
The horse are warning other horses, but the eyes are on back, the tail is swinging and like kicking in the direction for the other horses, but not to really kick. If that horse will not go away, there will be a real kick. And it is a not so soft kick. It will be move.
So it's some sort of like ultimatum where you're saying, oh, you better kick now, you better move, otherwise it's going to be trouble.
Yes, exactly. This is about the respect. This horse, young horse maybe, or a brave horse, just want to go in one level up in the herd, and he will get against the power need to go, yes.
Because they do that, right? You said it the other day. They have a hierarchy. They have a...
Well, they do that because why? Young horse could not try. They are older horses. If that older horse could not hold his position, then I'm sorry, you will go a little bit lower. For that reason, this is not always beautiful. My horse is bitten and kicked.
Yes. I see. So there is a hierarchy within the, how do we call it, the herd, within the herd of horses, and some survive, some don't, and it seems to be not related to the age. It's not related too much to the age.
No, it's not related to the age.
So it's really meritocratic. There is no, I see. All right.
Now, of course, the younger horses are the lower, but if still they are very young, they are under a mother protection. And in what level are mother, then other horses need to be taken into account. Because mothers will protect them.
Interesting. And how do they prove their leadership between each other? Fights and bites, I see. And also, do they fight with their hoof as well? Like, do they do that?
More with the hindquarters.
More with the hindquarters. Ah, right. I see.
Yes. And if we some strange people go into a herd without permission, it's very dangerous if you don't know where you are. For that reason, in Latvia, some people are so brave to come into a completely unknown herd just to pet a horse. It could end very painful. Okay, in this stable, there are the horses like in my stable, like with good relationship with people, that horse didn't kick someone. But still, this is very dangerous to go in the herd. If there will be stallions, oh my God, pray for your love because your life, because you cannot run them away. They will act like you are trying to compete with them.
They've got very competitive attitude, stallions. So I see.
Yes.
And you can really get hurt, but also you can really get killed as well, I presume. Yeah.
Yes, I am not kicked, but one horse stepped on my feet. It was painful.
Did he break any bones?
No, luckily not. For that reason, you cannot go with horses with naked feet. If you are not playing Russian roulette.
Oh, I see.
This is like a Russian roulette.
A roulette with four bullets. No,
yes.
I see. Daina, let's go back to, so we find a place that usually in the interland or just right outside Riga, there are some institutions, some stables that provide you a horse that you can rent and you can possibly initiate some sort of the training that has to do with nature horsemanship, which is more respectful towards the animal.
Yes.
What do we do then? How do we got this Pat Parelli, which is this American
yes.
I don't want to call it, can I call it cowboy? No.
I don't know. I think he's a cowboy.
So he commercialized this system, which is made by 7 points, I understand, or more than those. How many? Seven. Shall we look at them one by one? Are you okay with that? Beautiful. So Pat Parelli.
He's from America, and he developed those principles of seven games. The first game is most important. This is, I will start in another case. If you go to our stable, you can arrange that our main trainer Armands will show those seven games. The first will be, he will explain what is about, why it is about, because people are predators.
Yes. People are predators.
Yes, because we smell like a blood.
We smell the blood, whereas the horses are food.
Yes, for that reason, they are automatically scared. For that reason, those seven games is important to show that we don't eat them.
The reason why you need one of these rules that we're going to see is because the first impression that the horse has of the human being is that he can be hunted.
Somehow. Yes.
All right. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, the first game is about friendship. This is friendly game, call it. Horse don't need to do anything. Mm-hmm. But we do something. We touch in every point. We touch ears. We touch a mouth. We could touch under the tail. Everything. And horse need to let to do that. And it's not easy to touch all horses in all points of horse's body.
Ah, so you need trust for that. I get it.
Yes, exactly. Uh-huh. So you will not eat them. They could be relaxed and enjoy. Okay, now people will do something. I don't know why, but if I stand still, nothing happens. Okay, I will stand still.
How long did it take for you to be able to touch all those points with your horse, with Kresa?
With years was a little bit longer than with other stuff, but it's pretty fast. I think 3 sessions.
All right, so first one is friendship. We get to be more familiar with the horse that thinks that we are predators, but the fact that he allows us to touch them in all these spots, he establishes trust. I get it.
Yes, and the horse needs to be feel it, relax it, not like, okay, I will freeze, then they go away, and then I can relax. No, the horse must be relaxed in that point. We start with those carrot stick. This is like an extension from our hands to be in safe distance at the beginning. Because first you touch with the carrot stick. It's about 1 meter and 20 centimeters long. The longest is 1 meter and 20 centimeters about. Yes, and then you can come closer. You can see by horse eyes and horse ears and the tension in his neck, or is he chewing? If he's chewing, then he understands something and is more relaxed.
I get it. So you touch the horse with some sort of prosthetic at the beginning, and then slowly your hand gets there.
Yeah, I pet with that stick. I pet just, it's great, it's okay. In all things, all stuffs. And
so we got friendship now. What else do we need? What is the next point?
Next point is porcupine game.
Oh my goodness.
This means the horse needs to respond to pressure. Not against, but go away. Because at the beginning, they will stand against. If you push, they will be persistent. But they need to. If they feel the push, they need to go away from the push.
Like real friends, the first time that you have a fight, after you gain friendship, you find the resistance to that. Yeah, makes sense. You know, when you really get along with a friend, but you never had a fight with a friend, the first time that you have a fight, you usually clash.
Mm-hmm.
Usually. Okay, so perfect. So the first time you apply some pressure, there's the porcupine. It's called, why is it called the porcupine?
Daloņcūkas in Latvian.
But why is it called like that?
Because you touch in one point. Mm-hmm. You touch in one point, no response or against, then harder. It's not about energy. It's not about the big places. It's about one point.
Yes, makes sense.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah. Second game is like a beginning for riding. Because if rider is asking to go sideways or backways or something, you put the legs, and this is almost the same. You need to avoid the pressure, but not to like scary one. Avoid the pressure, do something, and you release automatically. if horse is doing, but you need it automatic release. For this porcupine is the same. You push in that point, and if horse is moving, you push it away. You don't push at the, for, I don't know, till the end of the field.
So you get the horse accustomed already to what you're going to do when you're going to be on top of the horse.
Yes. There is a next is a driving game. How you can drive horse with a bigger field, not only one point, but like going with energy. You imagine that you have a bubble and you're pushing the bubble against the horse. He needs to respond. He needs to keep the distance and going. If you are going on horse, he must move back. Or if I'm going back, he needs to come to me. So we are in the same bubble.
But how do you train for this exercise?
Need use imagination. Like this is like a bubble we are pushing. Not always happening with me, but I use them both hands in front corner and back quarter and then push. This is about riding the same. Because you ride mostly about energy. You put energy up or late a little bit down. And for that reason, you can change speed for horse or change direction by small little movements, and horse need to read them from your body. And all those games is in four levels, that the suggestion, ask, say, and then force. You need to go from the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to get more information and split it together.
Yeah. So absolutely, you have to gain the respect of the horse. There's no way. So you have to start from the beginning. So you gain friendship. You apply pressure with the porcupine game point, and then the third one, which is driving, I understand, right?
Yes.
You start to get in the horse accustomed to share your territory, to share, to move.
Like an energy box, yes, that we are in one energy. The horse needs to read my energy.
Mm-hmm.
If I expand it, if I keep it closer. For that reason, that people who are practicing meditations and yoga, it's easier to get that feeling, how to feel energy. Energy bubble between your and horse.
Why people that do yoga have it easier in that sense?
They are easy to imagination, that energy bubble. They can manage energy better. Because in meditations, you need to think about energy between eyes or on heart or in, I don't know, fifth chakra or something.
Is there a language of hands and gesture that you have to learn? Because at the moment, I guess, you are using your hands to communicate with your touch and your hands to communicate with the horse.
Yes, at the beginning I touch, and then I could just go. We have distance between, and horse will respond and going in that direction where I ask. It could be sideways, it could be a backwards for horse. Next is yo-yo game. It's about going backwards and coming back to me. There is about balance too. If I asking young horse too much backwards, he won't want come back to me, because you was just asking so far away. I'm scared. You are like scary. You are, I don't know, hitting me with those rope or something. Yeah. For that reason, we always can jump to friendly game. That's a magic about friendly game and all other games. If you are trying to push too hard, you didn't know that it will be too hard, of course, but the horse are afraid. What are you asking? He doesn't understand. No capish.
No capish.
Yes, and you need to go to friendly game. Okay, let's relax, be calm, and then we start again with level down. Don't ask too much for that horses. And with yo-yo game, it's easy at the beginning to get too much. Because you need to move the rope, that horses will go backwards.
We talked in the past about the way that horses are treated in rodeo. There is more fear involved than respect, or there is still respect in rodeos between horse riding and horse rider and horse, in your opinion?
In my opinion, this is more about fear.
It's more about
fear. And you broke the spirit of the horse.
Mm.
Because mm. he was in trap, no place to escape. Mm-hmm. The predator is on the back, mm-hmm. like a lion is on back, and you can do anything. I think in the soul you could die. Mm-hmm. Of course, it depends from the horse. There's a high spirit horses, they could live with that and go fine.
There are horses like that, right? There are
yes.
horses.
Yes, but for other horses, I think this is a pretty awful thing to be in the rodeo.
Okay, either you survive with the predator and you like that game, or you, or your spirit dies with it, because there's too much fear in rodeos, too much crazy stuff. I understand.
Yes. Of course, they could, it could be fixed, but it will take a lot of time, more time than if you be gentle at the beginning.
Yes. And what happens next? So
we have cycling game. This says horse need to run, go, walk, trot, or canter around me,
mm-hmm.
and stop if I ask. Stopping is about driving game. By mm-hmm. stopping, I'm looking the horse's hindquarter, and he needs to move that away from me, like with those touches with the hand. If at at the beginning that game was I touch and move something, he needs to move. From driving game, if I need want to stop horse,
mm-hmm.
stop to circling around me, I need to drive the hind quarters away from me, and horse stop.
Super clear.
The driving games is about energy more. You push energy a little bit higher, then speed will be higher. But if you like relax and be relaxed, then it could be a walk. Or even stand still, but in distance.
I see. How many points have we spoken about? Four or five? How many? Four, probably. Five.
This is, we have five. There's a sideways.
Mm-hmm.
If those, I didn't do all the three times per week, only teaching a cressa, because two times I was riding myself, and the one time I was teaching a cressa, or two times cressa. But that, fifth game, I think it was after 1 month.
1 month.
So long ago, because I need to reach better response to porcupine game and driving game.
Mm-hmm.
If those first three games are not almost perfect, you will have a problem with the next other ones.
But
if I saw that something is not perfect for cycling game or sideways game, then I need to go back those second and third game, what is porcupine and driving game.
I see.
Yeah, it's complicated, I know. But now you go cycling, then you stop, then you go backwards, and then you need to go sideways, and then, okay, come to me, okay, then cycling in another direction. You get the horse mind, like horse mind fitness, I will say. The horse not go, okay, now we're cycling 10 minutes, I just run around. No, my dear, you will have a different task to do. You need to listen to me, to be attention on me, what I will do. Because if the horse will not listen what I'm asking in or suggest with the first level, then will be the next level. And the purpose is for horse not to get till fourth level. Because
mm-hmm.
I was always friendly. It's okay. We are friends. And now you get the fourth level. Okay, what I did wrong. And horses tended to think what I need to do to not wake up that monster and that human that was very kind. And yes.
I get it. So it's all about establishing this balance between the predator human being and the horse becoming, losing their initial, their primitive identity and becoming something else, something different. These levels, what are they in total? Four levels?
Yes.
So we've been talking about games of Parelli, but now dealing with the horse, the levels have to do with the pressure that you apply. Not with the, probably with the way that you delegate the horse, right? The degree of the degree of strength that you use, maybe.
Yes, because the first one is touching air around the horse, then those. Feather. Okay. The first one need to touch air around the horse or on the horse. Then the feather.
Yeah.
Yes. Then is muscle, and then is bone.
A beautiful muscle sources. Beautiful. You can see.
Yes, and this is attention. First is the suggest, like think about it. What? Let's run, or let's stop. You think we could stop. Then okay, I will say we will stop. That if horse not respond, then okay, stop.
I see what you're doing. Okay, so you're using the carrot stick to. You're swinging it in the air gently, something like that.
Yes.
Like an orchestra director, something like that, more or less. Okay.
Yes.
Then that is not enough. You move towards the muscles.
No, the first is feather.
Feather.
Skin and feather, which touch a little bit the horse.
And after that, you're touching the muscles.
Yes, it will be more painful.
Which is more
for my opinion, but your, for horse, not always. As not I see from my horse, she's very thick skinned. Depends from the game. Need to keep the gentle way too. It's pretty hard from a distance to touch horse with a gentle way with that carrot stick, because at the end there's a rope. You need to touch with the rope, but not too hard.
Super clear. So all those levels that we're talking about, they have to be used in a slightly different manner according to the game.
Beautiful. Yes, and fast. And at the beginning, that those levels need to be slow. You can extend the first, second, and third, and only by exceptions they'll go to fourth. But later you need to split everything in half on the second. Mm-hmm. Very fast need to go.
Like almost like a drum. These levels of these different levels are made in order for your will to be followed. The horse rider wants the horse to follow his orders. Let's put it like that. The first one is with a carrot stick, touching the air.
Yes.
So moving it in the air, imagine with some special movements. If the horse doesn't comply to that, it doesn't obey, we're moving towards the feather.
Yes.
The skin, which he doesn't like already, not too much. But if he doesn't comply after that, we touch the bone. No, we touch the muscles.
Yes.
And after the muscles, we touch the bone, you said.
Yes, that means you can imagine how strength need to be kicked, like I could say, to touch the bone.
Yes, and what
I cannot reach. I have not so power, honestly.
Do we got any Parelli games left?
We had the sideways, but it's about going sideways in normal direction, not by diagonally, and the squeeze game. The squeeze game is last but important, because like Pat Parelli says, that horses are paranoid.
Yes,
For that reason they are for short ang spaces, like horse trailers. This is I will kill there, I will not step there. For that is the squeeze game, to squeeze you and between something from what a horse is afraid. At the beginning, the distance between you horse and that thing from what he's afraid is a big. And then you go like in infinity symbol, going closer, 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 closer to that. And so a horse could come very close, the thing he was so very scared, because he was doing your this movements circling in those infinity.
Why is it called the squeeze game? I didn't get it. So
because the horse is squeezed between me and that thing, but it's very scary. It will not go outside my back. Anything. It could be like anything.
Wall. Like a wall, even.
Yes. Because this teaches the horse to get through angst spaces. Not to be afraid that he will stuck there and will be killed there, but it's okay to go through something very small. They will be afraid to step in trailer, to go in short box, to go between cars. If they are filming, some horses was participate in a theater filming.
Yes,
and they need to go through ang steps to step up to go on scene, and for that that they need to be trained, because there's a dark ang and unknowing situations, and the horse need to be really relaxed and open-minded that nothing will happen, everything is safe.
On that note of talking about the set of a movie or theater, or since we finished with the Parelli games and we established all the different levels to deal with the horse, should we take 2 seconds and talk a bit about your experience in this Latvian Western movie that has been done recently, Wild West?
I was horse personal assistant, as I call myself, for couple of horses, and our stable provide 4 horses.
Wild East is called, which has got a quite cool name. I like it. A Latvian spin on the definitive American film genre, complete with horses, hats, and 6 guns. The film takes place in the second half of the 19th century, and when we have also manners, Baltic German manners involved. We have a wedding, we have aristocracy, and so it's very interesting because it's a Western that has been made with some Latvian scenario, I understand. But there are mountains, I see.
Yes, for Latvia, maybe this is not, for Latvia, this could a small mountain. For other countries, this is a nothing. But the scene was in those young couple need to run up in the mountain and left the horses lower. And then another scene was about those people who are hunting them.
I see. So it's like a chase. I get it. It's like the photography seems to be amazing. How was it? Did you have fun? Did you enjoy it? Tell us a bit about it.
The filming day? Yes. Mm-hmm. I like it very, because I was the first time in filming. Thank you for other stable who invited us too.
Yes.
She's very good with horse teaching for movies.
Mm-hmm.
Her horses were supposed to participate in other movies too. Or horses, some time to time, if there is a need for support, or the producers are searching exactly our stable. But yes, we started early morning, and then waiting. Like if you know how feeling is going, is nothing, and then it's going do that, the same and the same again, and then is nothing time period. But with horses, this nothing time period goes very good. Mm-hmm. Funny, we could talk, see everything. We had an adventure in that filming day, because the horses who were left lower in the mountains was not holded by anyone or anything. They need to stand still. But we as assistant for horses could not attend in this scene, because there was filming happening. And for after a 5th episode taking our horses thinking, why I'm standing here again? Nothing to do. Let's see what is there. And then one step, other step and they are watching, oh my God, they are trying to go somewhere.
Oh, no.
We can do nothing. We could do nothing. We just waiting those cut name so we could search for horses that was gone, because the one horse is initiate and the other horse is, okay, she's going. Why we are standing like stupid ones? Okay, let's go.
Again, the leadership situation, right?
Yes, I think the same. Yeah. But at that point, we were thinking what we will do in awkward place. We don't know where it was.
Yeah, everything was. There is a degree of unpredictability, because we're talking about trying to establish a confidence between the horse and one person to start with all those rules that we talk about. And then we bring the horse in a scenario that is full of things that the horse doesn't know. So it's quite difficult to avoid surprises or things like that. Times that I travel through Latvia in the countryside, I get the feeling that it looks a bit like a scenario for a Western movie. Sometimes it looks like Colorado or whatever it looks, because of the beautiful lakes that you have, the trees, the tall pine trees. It really looks like, mountains aside, but it really looks like a perfect scenario for a Western. You know, it does, especially with the wooden houses around and they. Yeah, Kresa was in the set as well.
No, Kresa was too young at that point. We had other horses. That was 3 years ago.
Okay, so the movie was shot 3 years ago.
Yes, scene by scene. Yes, it takes quite a lot of time, because one horse is not with us anymore.
There is so much that happens when you learn how to deal with a horse and everything that you've done, and it's been 10 years, right? Are you trying to be in a relationship with the horse changes somehow the way that you are privately with human beings?
I think always positive. At the beginning, I was only there for relaxation. I was not attend to learn something new. Mm-hmm. But time is going, and if I was not every week next to the horses, I felt very miserable, mm-hmm. angry. For that reason, I will keep going there again and again. And with horses, you need to think about your emotions. You cannot be frustrated, because then the horse will not listen to you. If you are giving those next levels to third and fourth to bone muscle, but you didn't ask the first two ones, the horse will not understand what are you doing. For going like searching, and what are you asking? For that reason, you need to be more conscious with your emotions. What are you doing? The same you can apply to people.
Yes.
Because you are tend to be more relaxed, not to go so deep in the emotions, more analyze what are you doing. And with people, you can do the same. You are not so nervous. Because with the horses, you cannot be so nervous all the time. And it comes like a habit.
It might work like anger management for people that lose it.
Yes, if they don't give all the anger to the horse.
Mm-hmm.
If they are so loving to horse, they won't do the horse pain.
Mm-hmm.
Because not all people with anger could do that. I think I know the people, sometimes they are so angry, they have, they could beat anyone, but with horses will not be that.
Mm.
I was once going to riding very angry, because I get a call from teacher school from my kid. He was not attending private lesson for music school.
Mm-hmm.
He was thinking he will escape one-to-one lesson with the teacher. He was so angry coming into the stable. And they give me a horse who is usually very lazy. So that means I need to go to level 3 to get some movement what I need to do. I was so determined. Okay, now you do everything what I need to do. I come up on a horse, started to riding, and the horse was listening. But every smallest move that I asked, I could use only level one, and everything was done. That means I was so concentrating to get what I need, mm-hmm. go forward, go sideways, go backwards, go around, trot.
You managed to do that by using your anger towards the school.
Yes, because I know I cannot beat a horse without nothing. For what? Why I should do that? For that reason, I was so determined. If I need to go to next levels, at that time I was hard to going to level 3 and 4. I was so sorry for horse. I gave him more time and more time, but horses use it like a child. They use it. Okay, there are no borders. Na 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 na. I can do what I want. I don't want to stop. Let's go a little bit. You don't say anything. You just okay. Say. I don't care, but if you go after as soon as possible with those level second and third, then okay, now I'm listening, fine, okay.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Super
clear. They're pretty smart, yes, like a small child, always checking borders.
Mm-hmm. And now, how do you do that very quickly? How do you check borders very quickly?
At the beginning, it was pretty hard. Because I was not so confident what I'm doing. If I'm doing everything clear for horse, am I doing everything right? All my asks are clear, understandable. Not like a mission, going back or sideways. What do I think to go? No, we're going sideways. No discussions. I was not so confident. Now I'm confident. I know what I'm asking. I know that I did ask correctly. And if the horse is not responding, I immediately go to next levels.
I guess something to say from somebody that doesn't know enough and has been watching too many movies. But the movies sometimes they tell the truth. I don't know. I guess one thing that it was always very charming, the horse itself is one of the most beautiful animals ever around. It's light and heavy and strong and beautiful and well-proportioned and... But the horse rider itself, because you see, like people that never been like me, for example, that have never ridden a horse. As you said, we said one day to each other, like the first time it felt so tall, so high and so dangerous. Yes. And so much out of control. There is so much out of control happening in that situation. But the moment that you take your path, what you've done with the horse in 10 years. There is some sort of, it's so cool to see that, to imagine that the person that rides the horse, like Daina, is not afraid that much anymore, like because you've been through different situations. So the fact that you can be in a different situation, you can be in a specific situation with the horse, but you maybe have learned to care a lot about the horse, that you stop caring too much about yourself. For example, let's suppose that I'm learning not to be afraid and I'm learning how to ride the horse. I'm learning all those games, okay? I'm learning all the games, all the Parelli games. I am confident with my 4 levels. I'm not perfect, but I'm confident. I'm a confident horse rider. The moment that I happen to find myself with the horse in a new scenario, maybe in a path surrounded by woods, in a new scenario that it makes me think that the horse might react wildly to it, the degree of fear that I have for myself to fall down and injure myself or even die is going to be a bit less important because I'm also worried about the horse.
Yes, I'm worried about how we both can safe go through the situation. I take responsibility for the horse because I'm the pair. If I'm riding horse, I'm the leader. The horse could be afraid, could jump sideways or look with scary eyes, but I'm that taking decision. No, this is not nothing. We will not be afraid. For that, I need to feel myself inner, not afraid. So the horse will feel okay. The leader is not afraid. She's calm. She's not tense. Okay, maybe let's not be afraid. Like, I'm showing what emotions I'm feeling with those calmness and maximal calmness, because sometimes I'm afraid too, but I'm not showing that in that way that my hands are shaking, my feet are grabbing the horse. That is the most terrifying thing that people without experience do. If the horse is scared and do some speed run, you will grab him even closer, but of course think, oh my God, that tiger is even closer in my skin there. Oh, I need to run even faster. For that reason, a good thing is to relax at that point. Very hard. I know it's hard if horse is running full speed and you need to be relaxed. How? Yeah. But yes, if you relax, then horse feel okay. She's not so tense. Why I'm running? Maybe we need to stop and start to listen what rider is asking.
Have you ever been in a situation where you felt like everything that you said so far was out of the window?
Is I was never on horse who race. No. But I felt at the beginning, I think after in 50 year or 40 year by riding, because I was help horse. That horse don't like if you push too much on that halter. You need to be loose. I push it too hard to stop that horse, but not using my body. I was not relaxing. Okay, now we stop. I was just stop. What is this? This is not the stop. This is the run full speed. And she was running in full speed. And then trainer said me, then let it go. Let that rope go, so halter is free. She will stop. I hear, but I could not do that. I felt off, and horse immediately stopped, because there was no that crazy thing who is grabbing him on his back and holding everything.
Almost like when you ride the Vespa in Italy and the person at the back doesn't know how to stand and you fall.
Yeah, I was that person on that horse. Now I know if something is going high speed, I just... relax.
Let's give a bit of a warning, a bit of a Usman Ibu to the people that live in Latvia and that are possibly riding in summer. And there are some massive, at the moment we have such thing that we call in Latvia dunduri, which are these summer flies, gadflies called, where usually when you walk in a very hot weather, they come and bite you, I think. And these are kind of 1 inch big, more or less, the ones that we're talking about, the normal dunduri or gadflies. And you have to learn how to kill them. And because sometimes the walk to the water or up to the beach is too long through the woods. And I'm talking out of experience, and you have to learn how to kill them if you want to kill them. Otherwise, you want to be attacked. But when we talk about horses, right? The horses are like a prey for a probably 4 inches bigger fly called horsefly, right? Tell us more about that.
That was pretty painful if they bite like a knife in the muscle, really, like a knife will be in the muscle.
And they go for the horse rider. They wouldn't go for people, but they go for the horse rider because it's with the horse, right?
Because you smell, if there's a hot weather, a horse is sweating. And automatically some sweat or some smell is on your feet too, or I don't know, legs or arms. But the same style of killing them. Because if you don't kill and just push them away, they will surround you again and again and again and clap and smash. And for that horse flies, you can imagine if. It was already blood full, then it's a pretty bloody look.
Yeah, absolutely. And also, always in movies, again, that's my only source, unfortunately, I've seen horses really losing it.
I don't know, even think about, because
Yeah, but you, because you remember the pain, probably.
It was a shock for me. I know they are big, but so painful. I didn't expect that.
Well, really. Imagine it's like a gadfly, a dundurs, on a bigger scale. That's what it is. It's a massive dundurs. When is the next time that you're going to see Kresa, your horse?
And, tomorrow.
Oh, there you go.
But you can imagine how beautiful it will be with the snow. And you should take a horseback riding in the winter too.
I should try and do that. Maybe one day I should. What is in the agenda for tomorrow? What are you going to do with Kresa tomorrow? What do you think?
We will do some exercises for dressage about shoulder out, shoulder in. This like a banana about folding in one direction, in other direction. This is for dressage elements and for horse health. So horse will be not stiff, but he's a little bit flexible on those points where he could be flexible. Mm. But newcomers could be taken into a ride with a trainer or instructor. Or the next option is to be teach it how to ride, because this is a different ways. One is to teach how to correct do a trot, for example, and to lead a horse, and other things is just relax and enjoy the nature. And the winter time is very beautiful, and the spring too. But in the spring or winter, yes, autumn the same. You need to find colorful till the leaves are on.
Well, thank you very much, Daina, for joining me. I'll see you soon. We're going to talk more about probably horses again. All right.
I know this is my weakness.
Oh, this is your strong point too, not only your weakness. Thank you. Ciao.
Okay, thank you. Bye.